Heard of some cavern no one's been able to enter?
Good thing, too. Elsewise, they'd have plundered it long ago like all the others.
Quite well.
Aven.
What?
I... just wanted to assure you I only want to look around the cavern. It's research.
Research?
Writing an adventure novel. Gathering material for it.
Mean to write up the coming of the White Fleet? Try, my dear. Mayhaps you could use my translation of the Song of Gilban and Dillion.
Gladly, gladly. So where's this cavern?
Gotta sail east from Caer Trolde. Caverns in a cove.
Saw the white whale. From the sea.
So long, and good luck with the white whale.
It'll show today. I'm sure of it.
I just saw it and tried to point it out to him. Now that reminds me, because there was a, you know, I think it was actually him, Envrid. There was a letter I picked up off one of the notice boards that talked about one of the white whale. And he has the same last name as Captain Ahab from Moby Dick. So I just thought that was really funny. There was a Moby Dick reference, and of course, just then, he's talking about the white whale that we just saw. Good stuff. I like it. Where did the two pearl divers go? I guess I don't have to do that. I just had to choose between the two of them. Okay. You just bought a copy of 10 Rebirth. People are saying it's a really great game now. You're talking Final Fantasy, Cora? X, not 10. Oh, sorry. X Rebirth. I went immediately to Roman numerals, sorry. I was watching Final Fantasy streams earlier, so I was like, oh, okay, yeah. So, X Rebirth. I have no idea what that is then.
I'd rather verify it now. Otherwise, I'll continue to wonder if he's not about to stab me in the back.
You have something of a persecution complex.
You needn't come with us.
I haven't intended it.
Space Sim. Oh, okay.
Somewhere.
Cool.
Ciri says there's a site in Skellige we must examine. Avalok's clearly hiding something from us.
Earlier, when we were in the Isles together, Avalok mentioned a laboratory. At one point, he wished to teleport there. To retrieve something. And he refused to take me with him. It was all very strange.
Sufficiently suspicious, don't you think?
Yes, I do.
So what? Want to just sneak in and root around?
Exactly. Coming with?
Yes.
Fine. Where is it?
On a small isle between Undvik and Spikerog.
Not exactly on our way. Just found out the sunstones on Ard Skellig. Cavern along the coast that we can only access from the sea. Gonna need some real magic to get in, too.
Go find this laboratory. I'll explore Ard Skellig. You can join me later.
Philippa, your eyesight. Only just recovered and magically simulated. Didn't you say you'd need some time to get accustomed?
Did I?
Huh. So I guess they fixed her eyesight. Nice. Because her eyes were scooped out with a fucking spoon in The Witcher 2. Yeah, her eyes were scooped out with a fucking spoon. No shit. I watched it happen.
We'll await you then.
Alright, what's Ermion saying? Philippa's boobs, though. Oh, they've always been hanging out. That's just a thing that sorceresses do, I guess. They just hang out their boobs all the time.
Yes, Geralt.
You imprisoned Ciri the first time you met her. Now you protect her while fighting against your own kind. Quite an about face.
First of all, I did not imprison her. She found me. It was her destiny.
Yeah, sure. Get to the second of all. Why are you helping her?
Because she is a danger. A mortal one. You look at her and see a human, a ward, a daughter even. I look and see the Elder Blood. A power that can destroy the world. A power that must be kept from Eredin's power-addled hands at all costs. Admittedly, our motives differ. Yet in spite of that, we share a goal. So you would be wise to trust me. Or at least try.
Tell me something more about Caranthir. Know him well?
Know him? I reared him.
Raised, don't you mean?
No, Geralt. I began shaping him long before he was born. For centuries, I brought together pairs of elves manifesting certain abilities, those able to manipulate time and space. He is the result of these efforts. Caranthir, a golden child.
Golden this is like a vampire with a tan. Yeah, he's a special kind of elf. Think of it like in the Elder Scrolls Saga, you have dark elves and high elves. He's part of the An-El. They call themselves the Alder Folk instead of the Elder. They are like the original elves. There's two tribes of elves. There's the An-Shade and the An-El. He is an An-El. In Witcher 2, you deal with an elf named Yorveth. The An-Shade are mountain elves, essentially. They're two different tribes. And they actually live on two different worlds, different planes of existence, different dimensions, so to speak. And so they are vastly different from one another. He is, just like the High Elves in Elder Scrolls, they have higher cheekbones, more high of ears, and they think themselves better than everyone. So like I said, there's a lot of correlation between this and the Elder Scrolls. I would say that Elder Scrolls more so got their idea from The Witcher, seeing as how that Andrzej Sapkowski, the author of The Witcher from Poland, wrote these books in the 80s and early 90s, far before there was an Elder Scrolls game. So, yeah, I don't know. Two of my favorite lore-based RPGs, so I don't know. I find a lot of commonality in the lore between the two of them, honestly. It's pretty awesome, and I love them both very, very much.
Charming world you and Elle have got. Could easily fall in love with the place. Tell me, how do you do it? Sit around playing flute, painting rutting unicorns in gorgeous landscapes, building ornately sculpted towers? And then you murder us without batting an eye, without a hint of guilt. How?
Do you humans feel guilt when you murder Enshay elves? Or dwarves? Or dryads? We are the same, simply because we both firmly believe others are inferior.
That's true, I guess.
From the look of things, pretty soon Ciri won't need your help anymore.
Nor yours.
True. She'll do whatever she wants, and I'll support her. What about you? Ready to let her live her own life?
I shan't force her to do anything, if that's your question.
Margarita any better?
I managed to accelerate tissue regeneration. She's feeling much better. In fact, we must bring Eredin here as soon as possible. Otherwise, I'm afraid these sorceresses of yours will start fighting.
Yes, I did Mad Men 12. Multiple times, actually. I beat The Witcher 1, I would say only about, not even a handful of times, like three or four times. I can't really remember. Witcher 2, in fact, yeah, Core 78 found me while I was playing Witcher 2 for my 9th time. I did an import from that game that Cora watched me play. I chose Yorveth. At the end, I chose to save Triss instead of help Yorveth get the dagger from Philippa, and then I did save Saskia. I did not let her die. I removed the big thing I impaled her with. So, it was a very, very good playthrough. I played on Nightmare for like my last 4 playthroughs of The Witcher 2, something like that. It was pretty awesome. I do very, very, very much love The Witcher Saga. One of my favorite lore-based games out there. I do love... Quick Save, it's a good game. I do love the books as well. I do have them all, but the one that was translated to English the day that this game released, a new one released in the States from the publisher that I have all the other ones from. So it's a true translation instead of just a fan translation. So yeah, I still need to get that book. But I love the books. I have the graphic novels that Dark Horse has made. Thanto Got No Life some days. Dude, the game is like 6 years old. Of course I've played it 9 times. You gotta call me a nerd. Really, guys? Really? Obviously, I know I am, and I'm not ashamed of it. Look at this room. Are you kidding me? All right, here. Let's go ahead and point out how big of a nerd Thanto is real quick. Let me change my OBS settings real quick. Okay, so we're going to talk about how much of a nerd I am. I'm wearing a Twitch streamer's t-shirt. I am streaming myself playing a game. My wife is playing a computer game on her computer, which is right next to mine.
Don't bring me into this.
If you look behind me, there's a Star Wars clock. That shelf there is covered in nerdy things that I've gotten from either collector's editions of video games, Nerd Block, Loot Crate. Let's see what else we got here. Ah, we have Mark Hamill and R2-D2 back here, sitting on top of my collector's edition of The Witcher box. So I have my collector's edition of Halo, The Witcher, Elder Scrolls Online. Back there behind Mark Hamill, I have my collector's edition of Star Wars The Old Republic. I have several pop action figures. I have Boba Fett, Chewbacca, Han Solo. I've got a big stand-up of Boba Fett. I got another Boba Fett from Fabrications. I have a signed, back there, there's a poster of Boba Fett that's signed by Jeremy Bullock, the man who played Boba Fett. Let's see. Here's Bobble Fett on my desk. My Star Wars Turvis. Let's see here. What else we got? There's a Boba Fett ink stamp thing done up there. I got my Mario Kart streamers above the blocks. I have my Empire Strikes Back poster, which is my favorite, signed by none other than Jeremy Glover, who plays Grandmaster Pycelle in Game of Thrones. You may also know him as General Veers in The Empire Strikes Back. He also plays the one of the Nazi guys in Indiana Jones. Nerd dude, nerd girl, playing games and streaming. Bro. Oh yeah, that R2-D2 back there, he's remote controlled, by the way. I want to point that out too. I can drive him around. Let's see, above my desk here, that poster fell down, but it's actually that one next to my desk. Bunch of Star Wars people. Got a Star Wars rock and roll stand one up there. Let's see, I got a map of Tamriel at the top, The Witcher 2's map in the middle. There's a map of Skyrim there. Another Star Wars poster there, and then another one also fell off that is actually the movie poster. You can't really see it, it's over here. It's the movie poster, Star Wars for A New Hope. It's the very first movie poster. So, yeah. And on top of that all, here's my PC. And my wife is playing Banished right now. And on her other screen, she's got the stream up. So, yes. I am very much a nerd, and very proud of it. I absolutely love it. As I was. The Witcher. Boom. There we go.
So long.
What's up, Triss?
Well.
You really have nothing to say to me? That's annoying. Anything good loot in here? The opposition in Nilfgaard. I guess I'll take that one. Take all that. A couple books I haven't read. Boom. Boom. And boom. Boom, boom. Alright. Travel to the island where Avalok's library is located. Thanto, one of these, I'm going to take a picture of my graphics card collection. Hey, man. Yeah, go for it. I would love to see it. You know, I really want to do that one. The Child of the Older Blood. That one sounds fantastic. Yeah, we're gonna do that one. It's involving Siri. I've got to do it like immediately. Got so much love for Siri. After reading the books, I've pretty much seen Siri grow up from.